Boxing superstar Terrence Crawford was a guest on Hot 97 this morning, and I'm going to share with you guys what he said in the interview. A lot of interesting things. He said, started off the interview by saying that he was sore. And they asked him, how are you sore? You know, you didn't get hurt in a fight. And he said that his body is stretching right now. He normally walks around 160-something, and making the weight wasn't easy. 47 wasn't easy. Which says in the future, 54 is definitely something realistic for him. They asked Crawford what's the first thing he ate the morning of the fight. I guess he said he had pancakes and bacon. And that after the fight, Crawford was sharing with them that he went straight from the press conference's after party at Topgolf, which actually I was invited to the party by the organizers and the hosts of the event. But obviously we all know I was going for Spence, so I don't think it's appropriate for me to go celebrate with another fighter, especially when I don't have a relationship with that fighter. But I did get invited there. So Crawford did tell Hot 97 that the night of fight, he just had like some chicken tenders and nuggets and some fries. But he really didn't eat a meal because straight from the press conference to the after party. They then asked, they told Crawford, you're the best fighter in the world. You're the best fighter right now, obviously. How far are you from fighting a Gervonta Tank Davis based on the weight? Crawford answered, Tank's at a low weight class for me right now. He's at 135. Crawford actually won his first title at 135. But Crawford went on to say that he's at 147, and that's two weight classes apart. In the past, and it surfaced this week, Tank said in the past that he would stop Crawford in six rounds. And before the Avanesian fight, Crawford answered like, hey, that's what he's supposed to say. You're supposed to call out the best and talk and get it going. So regarding the Tank fight, obviously it's not anything that anyone's talking about right now, but Crawford said he's not going back to 135 and Tank's not coming to 47. So if it did happen, Tank would have to come up. So the host asked Crawford, you don't think that fight will ever happen? And Crawford said, no, I don't think it's gonna happen. They then went on to ask Crawford about the next person up is Booth. And he said, that can happen because we're both in the same weight class. But Bud did say that at this point in time, he was looking for bigger and better opportunities, like Jermell Charlo. And then the host said, hey, you were getting chippy with him. He was ringside. They wanted to know from Crawford what he told Charlo. He said, I gave him a piece of my mind. Crawford said he was in the moment and he wanted to let Charlo know that he's coming for him too. Of course, Jermell Charlo is fighting Canelo Alvarez September 30th. It's one of the biggest fights in boxing. I can't wait for that one. Undisputed against Undisputed. And it's a very close fight. People writing off Charlo have no idea what they're talking about. Canelo's a superstar. Charlo's a superstar. Charlo is way up there on my pound-for-pound list. So is Canelo. And that is a major fight. They asked Crawford about his relationship with Charlo, if the beef is just like athletic, if they're friends. And he said, I don't care for dude. And they said, you don't like him. And Crawford said, it's not that I don't like him. I don't care for him. They asked Crawford, who else is out there? Since you just fought Errol Spence, that was the biggest fight. He did mention Charlo because he has all the belts and Charlo has all the belts. I mean, that was before the announcement of the WBO that they took Charlo's belt away and now Tim Zhu's elevated. But Crawford did mention the only major other fight out there for him is probably Canelo. However, Canelo is the undisputed 68 and Crawford says, I don't see me and him fighting. Crawford goes on to say that the highest he could fight realistically, he knows the limits, is 154. He's not going to try to go to 68 or 75 or do anything wild. He started at 35, champ at 35, champ at 40, undisputed at 40, undisputed at 47, and he wants to try undisputed at 54. Crawford said, them boys get big up there, like, because the guys fighting at 68 come down from probably 185 or one, who knows how much, to make 68, 78, 88. Crawford was being very candid in his interview, and he said, listen, I understand there's weight classes for a reason, and I respect the weight classes. On top of which, Crawford added that he's going to be 36 next month, so he has to take that into consideration as well, so 154 is his cutoff. Crawford was then asked, why did it take 5 years to make the fight with Spence, because he moved up in 2018, and he said, listen, I was with one promotion, doesn't really do business with the other promotion, all the other fighters were on the other side. We know the story, the Cold War, the other side of the street. All that's in the past. Present, Crawford, Spence did fight. Crawford won. Congratulations. He's now the undisputed. And now he cemented himself in boxing history. And as he would say, this is the Terrence Crawford era. Crawford says he understands that it was business, not personal, because his promoter would have probably done the same. The only bad part about it, it held him up for 5 years. So instead of getting the opportunity at age 31, he's getting it at 36. Crawford admits he couldn't get the big fights. He fought some marquee names. He fought some talented fighters, but he couldn't get the names that he wanted. The names that fans wanted to see him in the ring with. And that was one of the knocks, that he didn't have the competition. But that's not to take, I always said, can't take it away from Crawford. He did his job against anyone he stepped in the ring with. And we just wanted to see him against the best of the best, and we did, and we got the answer. Crawford then shared some interesting details from his perspective. He said he felt that they didn't mention his name on the broadcast, that they told him the WBO belt is not at the level, and that the champs at the time would not give him the time of day, even though he beat Jeff Horn, who beat Manny Pacquiao. So he felt like, hey, I beat the man who beat the man. And Crawford felt that because of all those actions, that he felt like they were trying to blackball him or try to put him in a position where the fans don't talk about him, the fans forget about him. That's what Terrence Crawford was saying. Crawford says that he felt that was very disrespectful, that when he would watch the fights, that they would mention Thurman as the champ, Danny Garcia as the champ, and who's the third person he mentioned? He said that Thurman, Spence, of course, Spence, but they didn't mention him, and he just felt that was disrespectful. What happens, Crawford says, the politics played a big part of it, and Deontay Wilder always tells me boxing is a business. Boxing is not a sport. There's sports and there's business. So promoters, managers, everybody has investment in their people. And, you know, it's a lot of belts in boxing, and it's sometimes hard to get things done. I'm happy this one was done. It's good for the fans. And look at the numbers they did. 650,000 pay-per-view buys. That's amazing. A lot of people predicted it would do 500. So it did way better than the expectations. And the gate, sixth best gate in Vegas history. Over $21 million. Crawford was then asked about his relationship with Earl, what he thinks about him, about the lead into the fight. There wasn't a lot of dirt or trash talk. It was just during fight week, you know, people cut weight. But for the most part, it was a very, very clean promotion. It was like a Manny Pacquiao promotion. Manny never says anything bad about anybody. And Crawford says, I'm a fan of Earl Spence. I like Earl Spence. Crawford reveals he's been a fan of Earl Spence since Earl was in the amateurs. And I'm going to tell you guys, if you know Earl Spence, it's very hard not to like him. He's a great person. He's a great dad. He's very chill, very respectful. He's a person that just, if you get to know him, you're going to like him. And that's why when I see all the people actually trashing him right now, you don't even know the guy. Listen, he went in there. He fought his heart out. He didn't quit. Crawford was the better man that night. And you still have to respect every fighter. You have to respect Earl. You have to respect Crawford. Crawford says he's never had any hate towards Earl, and whenever Earl has accidents or whatever, he always wished him well. He said he felt the fans kind of were trying to divide them in this one, but, you know, it's boxing and it's entertainment too. So the hype of the fight, you have to sell a fight, and it's pay-per-view. You have to get people excited. It's very hard to just sell a fight when it's no controversy. Crawford, very classy. You got to take your hat off him. He said that he's praying for Earl, and that he hopes to see Earl come back stronger. Crawford said he doesn't want to see anything bad happen to Spence because he's a fighter and he knows what fighters go through, and he just wants the best for him. Crawford said at this level, everyone's doing it for the same reason, to feed their family. So Bud says he wouldn't wish bad on any fighter. By the way, reports are that they made somewhere, each made about $20 million, maybe $25 million, as they should. They're the best of the best. They worked their whole life to get to this point. And why not? And hopefully they have a rematch and they do even more. Crawford was then asked, okay, looks like you're going to have a rematch, but because the way you won, why would people pay $85? And like I said, Crawford was very candid in this interview. I've never heard him talk like this ever, and I've been around him for almost 11 years. I've seen him at fights, seen him do interviews, you can imagine. But Crawford said, listen, Spence is going to go back to the drawing board. He's going to fix whatever he has to fix. He's going to come back stronger. He's going to come back hungrier. And the rematch, it's going to be intriguing. And that Earl will try to make the second fight different than the first fight. He does believe that Earl will try to make changes. The host then asked him, if the rematch comes up, would you take it? And then they fixed themselves. They corrected themselves. And they said, hey, you have to. It's in the contract. So there was a rematch clause. When you have belts on the line, the person who doesn't win always has the option to exercise the rematch clause. And it looks like Earl's going to exercise it. Now, will it be in 6 months? Will it be in 8 months? Will it be in a year? We don't know. But I can expect we're going to have a rematch at 154. Like I said, throughout this interview, Crawford was very complimentary towards Earl. He said, why wouldn't I give him the rematch? Like, because of him, this fight happened. We made it happen together because he made concessions. I made concessions, and you guys got to witness history. You got to witness greatness, Crawford said. So it's only right that I give Earl Spence the credit that he deserves. And if that's coming from Crawford fans, imagine all you guys that are trashing Earl Spence. That's the guy that was in the ring with him that respects him so much. So I think everybody should respect Earl Spence. Crawford then revealed that at the weigh-in, Spence told him, "You don't have to thank me." And Crawford told Spence, "You don't have to thank me." And then people asked Bud Crawford, "What did he mean by that?" And he said, "Well, without Earl Spence, this fight does not happen." The Hot 97 host then continued to ask Crawford what he said about all those rumors that the accident affected Spence, that we've all seen those videos of doctors analyzing. I mean, first of all, I don't know if it's even a real doctor who called into the show. Number two, if it's a doctor that gives you an assessment of a patient through watching him walk him in a boxing ring, I have to really question the doctor's judgment. But anyways, they asked Crawford. Crawford responded by saying that years ago, actually, I have the video on ES News. Crawford spent it from 2018. Crawford said, "When we fight and I beat you, they're going to say you stayed at 47 too long." Crawford then said, "Oh, they'll blame the accident." Basically, every fight you've had, they've either diminished his opponents or they took away from his win. Crawford said that when people asked him to fight Earl, he always said, "I want to fight him at his best. I don't want to fight him coming off an accident. I don't want to fight him when he has any setbacks. I want to fight him at his best." Crawford then revealed that when Earl Spence fought Danny Garcia, he was there and even got into it with Spence's family, who said, "You see?" And he said, "Yeah, he looked good, but he didn't look great. He looked good, but he didn't look great." And then came the Ugas fight, and he said that Earl looked phenomenal. Earl looked amazing. He was strong. And then he said, "Okay, now it's time." Like, and Ugas, remember, he came up to that fight after beating Manny Pacquiao. And I'll tell you guys something. I was in camp with Manny every day for 70 days, and that was the best Manny Pacquiao I've seen for that preparation. He was rejuvenated. He was motivated. He was doing everything. He was running. He was doing 3,000 sit-ups a day. I have those videos. 30-minute routine morning, 30-minute routine night. And everything was perfect. It was in good energy, good vibes, good. And Ugas beat him. And then Earl beat Ugas. However, after all the trials and tribulations, Terrence Crawford was happy the way it turned out. He said, "I could have just fought Earl in 2019 and we would have just been unified. And then we would have to fight an Ugas to fight someone else." So they're both the best in the division. They're both among the best in the world. They always said the winner of this fight would be pound for pound king. So it was worthwhile waiting. He did go on to explain, Bud went on to explain, like, "Hey, listen, he fought Danny after the accident. He fought Ugas after the eye happened into it." And Crawford made one mistake. Crawford said that Earl did not have injuries when the kid T-boned him. No, Earl did have injuries, and he was not able to train for a few months after. Nobody knows. I'm just telling Crawford for his information that in that accident with the kid, Earl had a bulletproof car and some kid T-boned him, and Earl did get injured in that. But he recovered, and like I said, no excuses. Two men stepped in the ring. Whatever happens, happens. Crawford was the better man. Crawford won. Congratulations. Not taking nothing away from him, so I'm not going to say anything. And there's no need to say anything. What happened months ago is not applicable to what happened last weekend. The host then asked, "How about you and Mayweather?" And he said, "Hey, I'll be great against anyone you put me in there with, any era. Our styles have evolved." That's what Crawford was saying. He paid homage to Mayweather and the other legends that have paved the way, and that the fighters today mimic the fighters that led the way. He feels that he takes it to another level and that he can hold his own with any of those guys. Past, present, future, he feels he can hold his own against any of them. Bud was then asked about him posting on Instagram, Eminem responding, and Eminem walking him into the ring, and Crawford says the following. He thought it would be dope to have Eminem walk out. They asked him, "What song do you want to walk out?" And he said, "I don't effing know." He said he's the type of fighter that likes to feel the song that he's walking out to. It has to have a meaning to him. It has to have a purpose to him. Bud went on to say that he's a big music guy and he's into all kinds of music, and that the songs pick him. He added that normally he'll listen to a song, he'll pick it. He said, "That's the song I'm working out to," and he'll play it the whole camp. But he said this time it was different. So for this fight, Crawford said he wanted to do something great. He said, "Who hasn't walked out a fighter besides Drake or Jay-Z?" He said it would be dope to have Eminem because you only have one shot. The song, you only have one shot, one opportunity. Shout out to Omar Miller, actor from 8 Mile, who's a huge boxing fan, by the way, huge. He went on to say that this song meant a lot because if he didn't win this one shot, he would never become undisputed welterweight champion of the world. Errol Spence going up in weight. Crawford's about to be 36. The belts are about to be dispersed. And if he didn't win, then he has to pray that he gets the champions back to back to back. And it would take 3-4 years to get to that point. Kind of like Lomachenko and Haney. That's why I thought Loma beat Haney and they said, "Oh, he didn't get robbed." And they said, "He did get robbed. He got robbed from the moment of opportunity because he'll never get a chance again to fight for undisputed. That's why it was so controversial in that case. This one was no controversial. Crawford won this one clearly, obviously. Bud was asked, did he know that Eminem was a big fan of his, a huge fan of his, and he said, I didn't. So when he replied to that post, he was like, whoa, that's dope. He was pleasantly surprised, and everyone ran up to him and said, you see Eminem? And he said, he didn't know because he's fighters. Sometimes, like, I don't know, Nonito Donaire didn't have his phone before the fight. Way off the story, but Nonito Donaire did an interview the day on Thursday before the fight saying that he hoped his own son gets knocked out. So Rachel Donaire took the phone away. So many times fighters will not have their phones coming into fight week for a lot of reasons. That's just one example. So Crawford was busy working out. He did not see his phones, but people came up to him and told him, hey, did you see that? Bud said he responded to Eminem, and Eminem said, yeah, let's do something. I'm coming out to the fight. And Crawford said, huh? Bud was shocked, and the host told him, you know, Eminem doesn't leave the house a lot. You never see Eminem anywhere. No one has, who here sees Eminem? He's never in any scandal. Everything, he stays home. And he used to train with Emmanuel Stewart. There's a famous story where Emmanuel used to bring him sparring. And one day he sparred someone, and they really beat the crap out of him, out of Eminem. And whoever he was sparring took the headgear off, and it was like a 14-year-old kid. And that's when Eminem stopped boxing. But there was a big producer in Hollywood named Jerry Bruckheimer that was doing the Dimitri Salida movie, and Eminem was chosen to play Dimitri in the story. So he's really into boxing. He's really, really a boxing fan. And so when Crawford, he told Crawford that he's coming, Crawford didn't believe it at first. He was shocked. Eminem came out to Vegas Friday. He met up with Crawford, and Crawford said, I was sitting there, I'm looking, wow, this is Eminem. He's one of the greatest. What Crawford probably doesn't know is that Eminem is the number one selling artist in hip-hop ever, ever, ever. He's number one. I think Jay-Z may be number two. But Eminem is the most selling recording artist in hip-hop ever. And Eminem is telling Crawford, I'm a fan of yours. And Crawford's like, damn. Like, Crawford couldn't believe it. Like, Eminem, like, it's funny how social media connects people and brings people together, but that's how that legendary walkout happened. It really meant a lot to Bud because Eminem, like we said, doesn't go out. You don't see him in the public. You don't see him do anything. So he said the fact that he was a fan of his and he did that for Crawford meant a lot to him. So that was basically the interview at Hot 97. Their video on YouTube is trending number 4 in all of YouTube today, which is very impressive. It has about 655,000 views. But I want to share with you guys a different side of Terrence Crawford. Very respectful towards Earl, very calm, very cool, but just candid and open, talking about shock that Eminem is his fan. Which I've seen everything in boxing. You know, I've seen Justin Bieber be a fan of Mayweather. I've seen a lot of things that you wouldn't necessarily expect, where you go, where you see, you meet a former president of another country, and he's a huge Canelo fan. So, interesting stuff, and definitely more to come, and I'm looking forward to the rematch. Earl Spence, Terrence Crawford, at 154. Stay tuned. Ellie Sekbak reporting.
I'm Ellie Sekbak reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekbak reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekbak reporting.